Okay, guys, this is part two, and oh my goodness, I'm blown away right now. I'm just blown away. So, while my video was uploading, and oh my gosh, the new hoops you gotta jump through on this platform is a pain in the buttocks. I had to delete the video and then upload it again because it's I don't like that beta studio. It's not good. So anyway, before I got into all of that, I was listening to, once mine was done, I was listening to, I think it was while mine was processing on my laptop in my editor. I was listening to Tim Foster's newest video, and oh my gosh, you guys, he said so many words from different scriptures that are Strong's numbers that I have looked up, that I have put on the calendars. I heard him, this is just one of them, because he mentioned several, but I heard him mention Habakkuk 3, and I'm like, I remember seeing Habakkuk 3 listed in one of the Strong's meanings. I'm like, which one was it? Well, it was 355 in the Hebrew, and it means a doe. A hind is a doe, a female deer. And that came up because 355 is the 21st, which is the seventh day of Hanukkah on the Enoch calendar. It's the 21st of December is the 355th day of the year. That's why I looked it up. Remember, I said that the days of the year were also significant. So I looked this up, and it means a female deer, and it's all over the place, guys, as far as what it refers to. I've come across it before. This is interesting. Let me show you that in a minute. But here's where the Habakkuk. It was Habakkuk 3:19. But that's where it mentioned the hind's feet, but it's not even, and these two are significant. Look how it says Psalm 18:34 equals 2 Samuel 22:34, because these two chapters are pretty much saying the exact same thing. And as a matter of fact, I guess these two verses say the exact same thing. And it is without a doubt, this is a song of David, of course, and then this is 2 Samuel. It is, I guess it's both David, but it's without a doubt speaking of the transformation of those who will be, the 144,000 who will be, and this is what Tim was just talking about, the arrows that are sent out, that are going to be able to do supernatural things, and the hind's feet has to do with being able to jump, like, and leap over the walls, and, you know, it's crazy. But anyway, in Songs, I was like, oh, it's in Song of Solomon. It says the same thing in these two verses, but I'll go to Habakkuk in a minute. In Song of Songs, this is also something that Tim just said in the video. I'm sure he has no idea that it's about the same thing that I'm looking at, which is the Strong's number 355. He mentioned in his video, because he was talking about, at the beginning of the video, he's showing a dream that Pastor Carl Gallup's had, where he could smell, this wonderful smell, smelled like flowers and everything, and that is the smell of the Lord. And as soon as he smelled that, he saw the Lord. Or did he see him, or he heard a voice tell him that he was home? Anyway, in Song of Psalms, chapter 3, verse 5, here's the hind's feet, where it's mentioned. It's talking about, it says, I charge you, O daughters of Jerusalem, by the rose. This is the bride speaking to this is the foolish virgins who are going to be left behind, the daughters of Jerusalem. I've gone over this in my study on Song of Solomon, the whole book. that there's two brides. There's the bride, who is the bride of Christ, and then there are the daughters of Jerusalem, who will be the left behind. They're the second bride. So, by the rose and the hind, the rose is beautiful, and the hinds of the field, the does, the deer, that ye stir not up, nor awake my love till he please. And then the very next verse is what Tim has mentioned in his video with Pastor Carl Gallup's dream that he had, that two other people had the same exact dream about the rapture. The very next verse says, who is this that cometh out of the wilderness like pillars of smoke? And I've covered this. This is a strong, the pillars of smoke is, I've mentioned that in the past videos. I don't remember what number. It has a different number, but it means the same thing. Perfumed with myrrh and frankincense, with all the powders of the merchant. I think powders was one of them. Yeah, 81, because it was for October 1st. This is the smell of him coming on his wedding day. And it also talks about him coming in his chariot of the wood of Lebanon, the cedars. Cedar has been one of the words that has come up in the Strong's Concordance. And he's talking about, Tim's talking about the chariots a lot in his newest videos. Gold is one of the newest ones that has come up. It is unbelievable, guys. I had to scroll through until I found it. It's on the 22nd. There it is. 1222 means gold. Oh my gosh, this is so exciting. So here it is. He made the pillars thereof of silver and the bottom thereof of gold. This is talking about his chariot. And then, you know, Yeshua tells those who are left behind to go, especially the foolish virgins, he tells them to go by, well, let me go find it. Yes, I thought it was in Matthew 25 regarding the parable of the virgins, but it's in Revelation 3:18, speaking to the church of Laodicea, these are the foolish virgins. And in verse 18 it says, I counsel thee to buy of me gold, tried in the fire, that thou mayest be rich. The gold that is tried in the fire, I believe, is what you have to buy, is the wisdom of what you need to do to become a wise virgin and to go in the last, you know, which were the second or the third watch harvest, as Luke says. You've got to go to them and get, because the wise virgins are the gold that have been tried in the fire, that thou mayest be rich, and white raiment, that thou mayest be clothed, that the shame of thy nakedness do not appear, and anoint thine eyes with eye salve, that thou mayest see. So see, they've got to go find the people who have basically the 144,000, those who are going to be telling them what they need to do to be able to get these things. So anyway, back to Habakkuk. Tim is talking about this a lot in his newest video, and he mentions that it's equivalent to the breaking of the seals in Revelation 6. I'm trying to find, because there's certain, I'm looking for the certain words. Okay, here's the chariots of salvation. Thou didst ride upon thine horses and thy chariots of salvation. I just showed you that in Song of Solomon. And, but it, this is not even, I mean, there's chariots of salvation, which is equivalent to the chariot that he comes on in Song of Solomon, chapter 3, verse 6. But the, also the hinds feet, that's what is the connection between the two. So as you see here in Habakkuk 3:19, The hind's feet, there it is. Strong is number 355 for the 355th day of the year, which is December 21st, which is the 7th day of Hanukkah. And here it is in Song of Songs 3, verse 5, 355. This would be the 7th day of Hanukkah. Oh, that's right, there's that. Oh my gosh, I forgot of this. It's the winter solstice begins that evening. It doesn't begin until the evening. It's not that it happens in the beginning of the day, but the end of the day. And here's another thing that he brought up that is in Habakkuk 3. As you see here, it's Hebrew 1007 for the 10th month and the 7th day. And it means a house of trouble or wickedness. House of wickedness. Look at this. You guys, I just found this after listening to Tim's video. I'd already done that first video. Remember what I was saying? It's not coincidence, because look at what it is in verse 13. The house of the wicked. House of the wicked. Habakkuk 3:13. House of the wicked. That's one of the strong numbers for the 21st. Do you see? House of trouble or wickedness. House of the wicked. You guys, this is not coincidence. And this, I just now saw this here. This is also another strong number. I saw that one first. Hang on, let me find it. Okay, remember what I said about the 7th, the 14th, and the 21st? Which are all the 7-day periods for the month of December. It's like every 7 days, 7th, the 14th, the 21st, and then the 28th will also come into play later. But this is where I saw it first, on December 7th, House of Wickedness or Sorrow. See, it's H1007 for December being the 10th month originally, and the 7th day. And then it's also just so happens to be the same number on the 21st. Oh my gosh, let's look at the 14th. Okay, so I don't see a 1007 here. But it is the 7th day of Hanukkah on the Enochian calendar that I have. Oh my gosh, guys, this is crazy. Do you see what I'm saying? That's why I know that looking up these meanings is not, that's with the Holy Spirit, it's all Him. And here it is. House of trouble, house of wickedness, on the 21st. I haven't done anything for the 28th yet, so I'll have to go back to that. I haven't got that far. But, oh my gosh, I think he said some other things. There's, like I said, so many of these, if not all, I believe every single one of these, this is why they're here. Every single one of these meanings pertains to the time that we're entering. I mean, look at this. The 8th day of Hanukkah on, now see, the original, where did I go to this, 21st? Okay, the original beginning of Hanukkah, the original 8th day, is on the 15th. That's the, according to the dates. But the pattern is replayed again, as I showed you with that little table that I made, with the Tishri dates and the Feast of Dedication, the Feast of Dedication and the Feast of Tabernacles. But then it repeats again, 8th day of Tabernacles, it's the pattern, see, symbolically equals the 8th day. So it's on the 15th and it's a week later. Because those 2-7 periods are the same. Remember, they're the same, but they're different. Because Pharaoh's dream, it was 2-7, they were both cows, but they were different. One was fat, one was skinny. There was two sets of grain. One was of good quality, one was not. There were two weddings for Jacob, two wives. One was the one he really wanted. One was the one that he was tricked into marrying. Do you see? So the two sevens are the same thing, but they're different. That's the pattern. Same, but different. There's another, yeah, that has to tie to the 144,000 because there are two groups of 144,000. They're the same because they are the chosen ones that were called out, mentioned in Revelation 7 and 14, but they're different because they're two different groups, but they have the same purpose. Oh my gosh, this is just blowing me away, guys. Let's go, we're going to go back up here. Okay, so let's go ahead and just move on down. We left off at December 7th, which is, I believe, is the beginning of things kicking off. I don't know that, that's just a feeling I have. And then the next day would be the first day of Hanukkah on the Enoch calendar. Going down to December 12th is supposedly a full moon. I don't know if that's true. Something tells me that the cycles are opposite of what they say they are. I don't know. Which would make this a new moon instead. But they're saying it's a full moon. That particular full moon is called a morning moon because it is... The morning moon is the last full moon before the winter solstice. So... They're saying it's this day. It was 40 days from 11-2, which was the Day of the Dead. So, all these things are connected. Anything that I mentioned to you, it's all connected. If you don't understand how or why, just ask me in the comment section and I'll tell you. So, going on to Friday the 13th. I think this Friday the 13th might be one of those not good days. Historically, this is not a good day. And it's 40 days from the 3rd of November, and the 3rd of November was the whole thing that was going on with the all the predictive programming that something was going to happen on 11-3 that didn't happen, and Seattle was supposed to be involved. So this is 40 days from that date. Here are the numbers, 12-13 and 10-13. Hebrew 12-13 means a stripping. To peel an onion. So I guess taking away the layers, maybe it's telling us that more things are going to start to be revealed that have been hidden. Because, you know, the layers of an onion, the inside layers are hidden until you expose the outside. So, I don't know. In the Greek, 12-13, to make plain or declare. That kind of goes with this one, what I just said. I didn't even realize that. Here's, I showed in the last video, 10-13 for this date means a place of a wall, and that could be tied to, the 10th day of the 10th month, Tebet 10, because that's the day that Nebuchadnezzar surrounded Jerusalem. And it said they put up a siege wall. Not sure if it was literally a wall or just a wall of, you know, soldiers that anybody trying to come out of the city to defend themselves would have to come into. I don't know. In the Greek, 10-13 is a preset, fully resolved plan. And on the Julian, it's November 30th. So that's 11-3. It can be 11-3 because the zero doesn't, you know, it's just a place marker. And, or it can be 11-30. And it could also be 93. I didn't look up 93. Okay, here we go. Yay! It's the nuts that are mentioned in Song of Solomon. Chapter 6, verse 11, is when the bride says, I went down to the Garden of Nuts and to see if the vine had flourished and the pomegranates had ripened, I think is what it said, or budded. The pomegranates have budded. And then it also means, in the Greek, it means evildoers or wickedness. What we're just talking about in Habakkuk, the house of wickedness. So, You guys. Wait a minute, did I do this wrong here? Look, this is the day we're on. What did I just read about? Here we go. I didn't realize I didn't. I did it over here. Oh, I forgot. I forgot that the Enoch calendar can have the same numbers as this Julian. I forgot about that. So it's over here. Okay, I meant to write down 93. That's what I meant to do. So, it was right there all along. Sorry about that, guys. So anyway, and also in the Greek, noun doesn't mean evildoers or wickedness. It means injustice or unrighteousness, which is the same thing. And then, okay, let's go back over here since I didn't finish. So, Hebrew 1:13 means Lord or husband or master. That's our king. And in the Greek, 1:13 means lawless. You see how all these meanings are pertaining? In Hebrew, 11:30 means son of one who shouts. You know. And it's from the root word, Hebrew 1959. That's what, because it, usually when I put it that way, when I have root, it means it's because this particular number means it's usually someone's name. And in order to get the meaning of their name, you have to go back to a different root. In the Greek, 11:30 means naked or poorly clothed. Poorly clothed. That goes right back. Oh my gosh, guys, that goes right back to Revelation that we just read, 3:18, about the house of Laodicea, about that you can get your white raiment. Oh my gosh. Cancelled by fire, gold tried in the fire that may be rich, and white raiment. The white raiment is the good clothing. It's not poor clothing, it's the good clothing. That's what you want. Oh, God. Do you see what I mean, guys? It's not coincidence. And I should probably go and... I'll try to go back and fill in some of these other ones, but... I'm not so much focusing on those ones since Hanukkah's over, but... let's just keep going real quick. So, on the 13th, Friday the 13th, it would be Kislev 30, or the last day on the Enoch calendar of Kislev. John chapter 11, the raising of Lazarus, Mary says to Yeshua that I know you, he will be raised on the last day. Doesn't have to be the last day of the tribulation, like some people think. The last day could be the last day of the week, the last day of the month. It just says last day. It doesn't say the last day of all things, of the tribulation and everything. It doesn't say that. It just says the last day. So, and it's interesting because it's the sixth day of Hanukkah. We know that six having to do with the ending of things because the seventh, which is representative of the Sabbath, is the rest day. So the sixth day is the end of the work day. So last day, sixth day, it's crazy. And then for the Hebrew 309, to remain behind or tarry. Church of Laodicea. and 309 in the Greek, recovery of sight. Oh my gosh! You guys! Oh my gosh, I had to come back here. Do you see what I'm saying? This is Church of Laodicea. They were lukewarm, so he spit them out of his mouth. They're wretched, miserable, poor, blind, and naked. Blind and naked! Oh my gosh, white raiment that may be clothed in the shame of thy nakedness do not appear, and anoint thine eyes with eye salve that they may see, so they are blind and naked. Recovery of sight, so they were blind, naked. Do you see what I'm saying? I hope you guys understand how important this is. Oh my goodness. This is crazy. Okay, before I get into this, guys, and this is a very important day, I'm going to do this in the next video and cut this one off here. Ooh, please be excited. You know, if nothing else, if it gets us to the next point, then so be it. These are stepping stones. So, now is not the time to give up. Okay, I love you guys so much. And I'm praying for you. Hang in there. Let me say the Lord's Prayer real quick. I haven't said that in a while. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, Yahuwah, Yahshua, HaMashiach. Yahushua, Jesus. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts or trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Our debtors, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory and forever and ever. Amen. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam. Blessed are you, Lord God, King of the universe. Okay, guys, I'll see you in part 3. I love you. Stay excited. Hallelujah. Shalom.